Let's try. I don't want to do that. Everything is dangerous. I'll probably save that for later. We just did that one. We'll go in order. We'll go boop, boop, boop around the room. Claustrophobic Rocketeering. This one's going to be fun, I think. Claustrophobic. Okay, claustrophic. So, tight spaces with rockets. This is going to be interesting. Oh, yeah. I see what we're going to be doing. 45 enemies. At least it's a small enemy count. See, I'm afraid to grab this. Not because of the platforming. The platforming's bad enough. But I see a wall there. And that wall, I'm worried, will open. And something nasty will be on the other side. Like, for all I know, it could be a whole bunch of spawns. Those bouncing blue, exploding testicles of doom. That would be awful. I don't know. Granted, I'm at 94 health, so I might as well attempt it now, right? While I'm at better health. Then later. Let me just see what's around the corners. Ow. Death is. Okay. Great. Now I'm at less health and less ammo to take care of what's over there. Great. Alright. Let's do this. Get a mega health, though. Nope. Okay. Clear. Good. Oh, shit. Death Knight. Please die. Thank you. Okay, which way do I go? Let's go upstairs. Less lava. Two rockets will kill this ogre. Ow. But they drop two rockets, so you get back your investment. No. I don't want to do the floating platform. Screw that. And 15 enemies will do our first save. I'm afraid this will Nope. Okay, we're clear. Good. Okay, good, good. Oh, shit! Shambler! Alright, where's that Shambler? There's that big, fluffy bastard. I'm really happy we got the red armor right now. Nice. Killed the Shambler, which means I'm going to be doing my first save. Big, big debate in the Quake community whether or not Shamblers are fluffy or, fleshy boys. I know Romero said that they are definitely skin. It's not fur, but I don't care. If I keep saying that, though, John Romero's going to drop in the stream and be like, "Hey, Jag, hope you're doing well. Your information about Shamblers is inaccurate." In which case, if that did happen, I'd absolutely fanboy and, like, lose my shit. Although, when I fanboy, like, It's happened before. When I fanboy, I don't, like, get emotional or hyper or talkative. I become, like, more quiet. And it comes across as, like, me being... It sounds like I'm being stuck up, but I'm not. I just become really quiet and just, like, really uncomfortable. Because I'm, like, so, like... You know. So it's awkward. Like, I've had actual streamers that actually have a following pop in randomly before, and I'm like, hi. Yes. And I just go really quiet. And it's, like, awkward. And I feel bad because the streamer will be doing a raid or whatnot, and... It's like, oh, we're raiding this guy? This guy doesn't even talk. And I'm like, people. Boom. Let's go back for that armor. We saw armor earlier. And I'm going to need it. Especially when we're dealing with rockets. Yep. Another tip to knives is, you probably know this already, but don't waste items. Like, a lot of times I'll intentionally leave items behind. So if I'm like at like 98% health and I see a health kit, I want to avoid it. I don't want to grab it, because if I grab it, I'll just go to up to 100. I only gain 2 life. It's a waste. So a lot of times I'll just kind of try to remember where I left stuff and then come back to it. Like in Resident Evil 0, yeah. I wanted to kill that Death Knight, but the ogre just kind of walked right in front of us. Boom. One of the tip 2 knives is if you jib an enemy, like what I just did there. Like if you jib a soldier, you don't get any ammo. It's weird. I don't understand it, but yeah, if you explode by doing way too much damage to them all at once, you don't get ammunition from them. It's an odd thing. Yep, I knew it. I had a feeling. I hear zombies in here too. You can't kill them by conventional means. You gotta explode them. Or quad damage them. Yep, down below. Not much of a threat to us right now. These ogres can be really annoying. Splash damage is always a good thing. Ah. Alright, I see a switch there. I'm not gonna hit the switch yet, because we're not ready for anything that might pop out at us. We'll grab this armor, though. Shit. Okay. A lot of times with ogres, when they fire the grenade, you don't want to back up. Sometimes you want to move forward. That way you're not... Because you move back... Your instinct when you see an enemy and they're shooting at you is to back up and go for cover. But if you back up when an ogre fires a grenade, it's very likely the grenade will bounce off a wall and kind of almost like chase you down. Whereas if you get in front of the grenade, unless there's a wall right behind you, you're clear. You're not going to get hit by that grenade. Main reason why I was backing up, though, is because I'm down my rocket launcher. I don't want to hit myself with splash damage. Like that. Alright, we got two more enemies left. I'll do my last save now. Let me change it on the board. Alright, we should be home free. Barring any surprises. We don't need that quad damage right now. Good to know it's there, though. Lightning gun, okay. Okay, well, Thunderbolt. Interesting. I don't want to grab that quad damage, because that quad damage might spawn in that last enemy. Which, if we can skip, then it's all good. But this is what I mean, I'm at 99 health. If I grab this, it's now gone. No. But it doesn't really matter right now, because we're almost done with the map, it looks like. You know what? Actually, I might just grab the quad damage. Because I'm remembering the switches that we missed. That I passed over, that I didn't want to hit. That's probably going to open the exit, and the exit will probably have a shambler or something guarding it. Now. Alright. Nice. Whoa! Alright, that's the last enemy. That was a nice surprise. I was not we walk on the water, get the red armor. Once you get the red armor, you go through the water and you end up being ambushed by the shambler here. That's really clever. That's really cool. Alright. Thankfully that, even though there's water texture, we weren't actually in water. You don't ever want to use the Thunderbolt in water. You'll completely kill yourself. If you do that. Electricity and water don't mix. Even in Quake. Alright, now we gotta find our way out. These were the switches, right? Yep. Oh, we just hit that one. Darn it. This way. Nice. I'm guessing that's the exit. Let's exit with style. Didn't have to rocket jump once in that map, actually. I expected that to be a thing, but yeah. Alright, that was a tight map. Could have easily been very unfair, forcing the player to fight enemies in confined spaces with rocket launchers. Could be really cheesy, but the enemy placement was done well enough, so you never really had anything right in your face. Really well done. I wish there was more shamblers, not shamblers, no, more fiends, actually. I think that they could have been used a bit better. Or just used more of them. Especially, I think it would have been better if we had fiends in the pit instead of zombies at the very end here. Besides that, great map. Really, really a lot of fun. Alright, let's change the board again and see what's next.